Bien.
Peter, so this is your late night at the office?
Melanie, what are you doing here?
Sorry to interrupt.
This is not what you think.
Oh, really?
Melanie?
Don't touch me.
Madam? Madam, please.
Melanie?
I said get your hands off me!
Calling the police.
Here we are. Living room? I decorated it myself.
It's nice.
Of course, there's a matter of a deposit. First month and security.
That wouldn't be a problem.
It worries me that you don't have a job, though.
Well, I signed with a temp agency, so I expect to have one by the end of the week.
Mr. Henley develops real estate. Big stuff. Apartments, malls. Just imagine yourself inside a big Monopoly game. You'll be working for Margaret Bateman, our controller.
I don't care, Jim. No, we ordered 5,000 units, and that is what we intend to pay for. Check your records. Yes, I will hold. Yes, who is this?
This is the new temp.
Hi, Melanie Brooke.
Hi, I'm Margaret Bateman. I'm going to be a while. Can you find my assistant? Jim. No, I know you have it, because I signed the order myself. I'm looking at it right now. Yes. No, I will fax a copy to you.
You'll be using this workstation here.
Are you familiar with Logic Ace?
Yes, also AccountTex 3.
Great. Now, Laura, if she decides to return within this millennium, will bring you up to date on the project.
I don't think so.
I did.
Where have you been?
The bagel man didn't have change.
Laura, how many times do I have to tell you the phones stay covered? And if not, I would like a better excuse than high finance with the bagel man. This is the new temp, Melanie.
Melanie Brooke.
Get her started on the spreadsheets.
I figure she'll be fine once she gets the ruby slippers. Hi, I'm Laura Brodigan.
Hi. I need 5 copies of this right away.
Here, sometimes this will do it.
No.
No? No, it's supposed to, anyway. And if that doesn't work, I usually try this.
Ah. Oh, great. Thanks.
You must be new around here.
I'm a temp. I'm Melanie.
Tom.
Oh, She's screaming for those copies. Mr. Henley, hello.
Just tell her we'll get them to her as fast as we can. Nice to meet you, Melanie.
Henley? You mean like on the letterhead?
Like on the paycheck. He owns the place. He's not supposed to copy things. He's also married. Of course, I hear there's problems. She's obsessive about this stuff. So watch.
Three pencils here, like this. Two pens, black ink, here, okay? Newspapers go here, folded and arranged by regions, East Coast to West Coast.
You're kidding.
Oh, no.
Once a month, they get some cheap wine and some processed cheese, and they call it a party. I think it's what they do instead of giving us a raise. Even the bigwigs come, except for Miss Bateman. Her idea of a party is doing a cause report.
So how do some of your aspirations end up with us?
My landlady had the nerve to ask for rent.
And what's back in Albany?
The past.
You see that building across the river?
Mm-hmm.
There used to be a row of houses there. Well, tenements, really. That's where I grew up.
You?
Should I say I'm sorry?
Your wife might appreciate it.
My wife? She might have once. There's not a lot left now. We're basically roommates with a joint account. Listen, honey.
Thanks a lot for your help.
Night, Ben. See you in the morning.
Christine. Hi.
This is a switch. You home before me?
Listen, I was going to make us something to eat. Are you interested?
No, I'm exhausted. We had another opening tonight. I'm just going to have a bath and go straight to bed. By the way, I'm going to be working four nights a week instead of three. Things are picking up.
You don't have to work. You know that.
Tom, this isn't a hobby. This is my business. Anyway, it should be convenient for you with all your late meetings.
Why didn't you tell me Mr. Raymond called?
Mr. Raymond? I don't remember Mr. Raymond calling.
I think I took that message. Laura was gone. I'm sorry. This cannot happen again. Laura, show her the procedure.
If anybody calls, make sure that you jot it down in the telephone log, okay? And thanks.
Sure. Do you need anything from the supply room?
Yeah, a new job.
Oh, you're going to need the access card. It's a spare master. Keep it.
Going down? Hi. My lunch canceled. Say, can I interest you in some of the best deli food that you have ever tasted?
That's okay. I brought my lunch.
Okay, let me guess. Tuna fish on whole wheat with an apple.
Egg salad and a banana.
Enjoy your book. You know, I read it. It's very disappointing.
Yeah, the butler did it.
It's only lunch.
I'm sick of egg salad.
So you're pursuing art as a career. You should let me see your work sometime. Perhaps I can help.
What's the matter?
Mr. Hanley, are you asking to look at my etchings?
I'm not doing very well, am I?
You're doing just fine. I've had a really good time, but it can't be 6 o'clock. I really need to get a new watch.
It's 5 to 1.
Ah, Miss Bateman calls.
Well, let's do this again sometime. Would you like that?
Great.
Maybe I could cook something for us.
Cook?
Yes, cook. I love to cook. We've got this incredible state-of-the-art kitchen in our corporate apartments. What are you doing Tuesday? Well, great. Listen, don't forget to bring your etchings up to my office.
What makes you think that he's seeing somebody else?
Just the feeling I get.
You want pictures of him?
Yes. How much?
Well, that depends on what you want. You want him just holding hands, or you want the whole enchilada?
The best you can get.
Well, surveillance, lab work, grand plus expenses.
Fine. I prefer to keep this on a cash basis.
You know, I'm getting to like you better all the time, Mrs. Henley.
I'll call you. Just one thing.
What's that?
Don't ever refer to it as the whole enchilada again. Powerful use of imagery, don't you think?
I've seen his work before.
Interested?
Oh, no, I'm just looking.
Well, let me know if I can be of any help. Thanks.
I didn't know Mrs. Henley ran an art gallery.
Yeah, she started it up about a year ago. Got tired of sitting home all day, I guess. What a life, huh?
But you had said there were problems.
Huh.
You mean like they might split up, or...?
Yeah, but from what I hear, it'll never happen.
Why is that?
Who knows? Appearances is my guess. Society column stuff, bad for business.
Each unit will have the same Venetian molding that you saw in the lobby. It's going to be marble in every entryway. And rest assured that everything is on schedule.
Do you mind if we take a look around?
No, go ahead, by all means.
Mr. Henley. Is everything okay, sir?
Yeah. Yeah, it's fine.
I gave him 24 hours to get it together, otherwise we're going to pull the order.
Terrific. Mr. Henley said you could take care of it.
Oh, you spoke to him?
Yeah, he was on the site today.
Giving a tour to the investors?
You know, looking around, showing them everything.
Good. Good, all right. I'll talk to you tomorrow, Jim.
All right.
Someone at my desk?
Mr. Henley had to check something in there. He said it wasn't important and he'll talk to you about it later.
This is a nice apartment.
Yes, the company uses it for entertaining clients, meetings. It's better than a hotel.
I'm not here that often, which is, why I can never find anything. Listen, I've got your drawings, and I spoke with my friend, and he liked them very much. He's very interested in meeting you.
Accept this. Look, Tom, we should talk.
What's wrong?
I met your wife.
My wife?
By accident at the gallery. She didn't know who I was, but I hated the way it felt.
It's over between Christine and me.
Then why don't you leave?
Because it's not that easy.
Neither is this. Tom, the timing just isn't right, all right? I've just come out of something. You've got your marriage to deal with. I'm sorry, I should just go. Look, I'm not gonna come back to work.
You don't have to quit your job.
I was just a temp.
Melanie.
Please, I just need to go home. All right? I just can't do this right now.
Margaret.
Hi, Tom.
What are you doing here?
I spoke with Jim over at the Paddington site, but my files were gone, so I was wondering...
I took your files. I plan to talk to you tomorrow about this. Come on in.
Everything in the Paddington's supposed to be top quality.
It is.
No, the wiring's not. I saw it, Margaret. It's up to code, yes, but it's inferior. Now, your records indicate that we purchased top quality, high-grade double sheath. What if I was to check the other luxury projects? Am I going to find the same thing? No, the difference adds up to a substantial amount of cash.
All right, Tom. I'm really embarrassed that you had to find out this way. You know, I thought we were over budget, so I cut some corners. And I invested the extra money, and it's good for us.
Without telling me.
I wanted to have something to show you, a decent yield. I mean, these things take time to come to fruition, and... Look, I will get all the paperwork together, and I'll walk you through everything I did, okay?
Okay. Okay. Let's go to the office right now. You can walk me through everything tonight. How long has this been going on? How long?
All right, I'll tell you exactly how long. Since the day you refused to make me a partner.
I didn't refuse. I never wanted a partner.
I am a partner. I helped you build this business.
Yes, and you get paid very well for that.
16 hours a day, 7 days a week, for what? To sit there and be told that I'm not going to get what's coming to me? Wrong.
That's enough.
You know what? What if I was to tell Christine about your latest little crush? What do you think about that, huh?
Get out!
You know, at least my husband had the guts to leave.
Fine. I'll call the auditor right now, and he'll come by first thing in the morning and check your records.
No. Listen, I'm sorry. Please, don't do this to me.
You are finished.
I have done everything for this company. No!
Get off of
me! No!
I can't believe this. I'm calling the lawyer. You're going to have a lot of explaining to do, Margaret. Your career is over.
Excuse me, you didn't see an airport limo here, did you?
No, I didn't. Tom? Tom, I forgot my drawings.
Didn't like the food much. Somebody had quite a fight.
Take her into the other room. I can't get her to calm down long enough to talk.
Well, how would you feel if you came in and found your boss with his head caved in? Funny.
Hey, Nagel.
So Melanie, suppose she'd be upset if we read her mail?
I don't think so.
I think he liked her.
This is just a
Did you know they were involved?
No, I had no idea.
Is it unusual for her to come in late?
Yes. Yes, it is.
I'm sorry, Laura. I just think it's better if I leave. I guess you haven't heard.
What?
Something terrible has happened.
Going somewhere?
Why? What's going on?
Bert Nagel, homicide.
Homicide? What's happened?
Are you the Melanie on this card?
How did you get that?
I take it that's a yes. Could I use your office for a moment, Miss Bateman?
Of course. Is somebody going to tell me what's going on here?
Exactly what I had in mind. This way, please.
Oh, Laura, dear, you look so upset. Why don't you take a little break?
Thanks, Miss Bateman.
So what time did you leave?
Around 9:30.
And where'd you go?
Home.
Right home?
Yes.
How long have the two of you been involved?
We weren't involved.
Somebody made dinner last night. Wine, flowers.
He made dinner for us. So?
So, it was a date, you mean?
No. I mean, we were just friends.
This gift card isn't just from a friend. What'd he give you?
A watch.
So you were going out?
No. I mean, not that way. Look, he was nice. I liked him, yes. But he was married.
You didn't know he was married until last night?
Of course I did.
Help me out here. You mean this friend who wasn't really a date, but who made you romantic dinners, brought you expensive gifts? Do I have this straight yet? Why are you leaving your job? Why this sudden urge to pack?
Like I said, I didn't want to be involved that way. I thought it would be better if I found another job.
The jewelry box was empty. The watch was gone.
I told you, I didn't take it.
Looks like dinner didn't go too well. Did you two have a fight?
No. I told him I didn't think the situation was right, and I left.
So you broke up?
No, we didn't break up. We said goodnight. He walked me to my car, I left and went home.
Anybody see you?
No. Not that I know of.
I wouldn't be planning any trips right now, Miss Brooke.
Am I free to go?
Yeah. Spademan, thank you for your help. I appreciate it.
Absolutely.
I came in this morning to quit. I had no idea this happened.
Well, unfortunately, it did.
Now, they may not believe me, but I'm telling the truth.
Then you have nothing to worry about.
Hey. strange for you. Mrs. Henley's alibi checks out. She was at the garage all midnight.
Good. Well, guess what? Melanie Brooke has a record.
Really?
Mm-hmm. I think I better talk to the police up in Albany.
Hello?
Ms. Henley, Jonas Slide speaking. Sorry to hear about your husband.
This is hardly a good time, Mr. Slide.
We had a deal.
Yes, I realize that.
I could come by if you like.
No, I'll come to your office.
Well, thank you very much. I appreciate your help. Restaurant up there filed charges against her last month. Seems she got in a fight with a guy, broke some stuff, guy needed stitches. She got off with a plea bargain, disturbing the peace.
Interesting.
That's not the best part. She was sleeping with a guy. So, let's go see what little surprise we have waiting for us in warrant court today.
I ain't even gonna count it, Miss Henley. I trusted you the moment I set eyes on you. I invented this little baby myself. I got mugged once and I swore that'd never happen again. I figure a man ain't smart, a man dies. Now, these ain't exactly what I hoped for, but I figure it don't matter now, huh?
Wait a minute. You took these the night my husband was killed.
Yeah, I guess that about wraps up our business, huh?
Well, have you shown these to the police?
Mm-mm.
These show her leaving. Did she come back?
Nope. I waited around a sec and I left.
Well, did you see anyone else come in?
Mrs. Henley, what I've seen is in them pictures.
Miss Brooke, this is the police. Miss Brooke?
We have a search warrant, Miss Brooke. Dan, go back there. It's Michael. I'm required by law to inform you we're looking for items believed taken from the scene of a homicide.
What? What do you think you're doing?
Read the warrant, Miss Brooke. Everything's there. This warrant also gives us the right to search your vehicle.
I don't know what's going on here, but I did not take that watch.
Melanie Brooke, you're under arrest for the murder of Tom Henley.
You have the right to remain silent. You have the right to speak with an attorney.
I appreciate you helping me through this.
I'm so sorry, Christine.
And thanks for taking care of things at the office.
It's the least I could do.
He depended on you so much. Margaret, something's come up. I need to talk to somebody.
What's wrong?
Could you come by the house later?
Of course. We're gonna get you through this.
Thanks.
Take a look. Who took these?
A detective I hired to prove that Tom was seeing someone.
Oh, Christine, I'm sorry.
He took these the night that Tom was killed. They're in order. They tell a story.
What do you mean?
I think I'm in a position of offering my husband's mistress an alibi.
What?
Well, the police claim she killed him in a fit of rage and fled. She says he walked her down to her car, she got in, she drove off, and there's proof that she's telling the truth.
It looks to me like they're arguing.
Yes, but she left.
Well, maybe she came back later.
Possibly. I also have a funny feeling about this detective I hired.
Why?
I don't know. He just acted very odd. Evasive. Like he knew more than he was telling me.
Miss Bateman, excuse me, but some guy keeps calling. He says it's urgent.
Well, who is it?
Says his name is Jack Smith, and he'll only talk to you.
Margaret Bateman, how may I help you?
Well, I'm kind of what you call it. Roving reporter. Doing a little story. How to deal with a boss. Especially at night. In his apartment. The big glass object dark.
Who the hell is this?
Well, why don't you come down to the bar at the Marine Tower and find out.
Look, I don't know what's going on, but I want to get out of here.
Okay. Well, we're going to try.
I didn't kill him.
Well, that's always a good place to start. Okay, here's the drill. We go to preliminary, the DA presents his case. If it's weak, they dismiss. If not, we file a plea and we go to trial. Okay?
And how strong is their case?
Well, I seem better and I seem worse. Of course, it's getting a little stronger now that we've learned about a certain guy in Albany. Got hurt real bad, I hear. I understand you got arrested. They charged you with assault.
I didn't assault him. I did, sort of.
Okay, in court there's no sort of. Why did you lie about the watch?
I didn't.
Then how'd it get in your trunk?
I have no idea. Obviously somebody other than me put it there.
Can you prove it?
You're asking me? Aren't you supposed to investigate?
Yeah, right. In my spare time. Tell you what, they don't have much of a case. Crime of passion, signs of a struggle. We plead a second, I can probably get it down to manslaughter. How's that?
What?
Happens all the time.
Look, if this is your idea of how you're going to defend me, I sure as hell don't need you.
Yeah, you do.
You listen to me. I did not kill him. I did not take that watch.
Got quite a temper there.
Not enough to kill somebody.
You're very photogenic, Miss Bateman. The way I figure it, why should I go to the police? I mean, they've never done anything for me except give me a hard time.
What is it that you want?
A respectable woman like you makes a mistake. Shouldn't cost her everything.
I asked you what you want.
$100,000 for the negatives.
I can't. That's impossible.
Now, Miss Bateman, you strike me as a very enterprising woman.
I have to think about what to do. I can't get that kind of money together.
No. I know that a woman like you needs time to think things through. I'm a very understanding man. I truly, truly am. We'll talk tomorrow.
You've got a visitor. Follow me.
You know who I am, of course. You fooled me that day in the gallery.
What were you doing? Checking me out?
No, Mrs. Henley, I didn't know that you worked there. Honestly, I didn't know anything about you.
You knew you were sleeping with my husband.
No, I wasn't.
You expect me to believe that?
It's the truth. What are you doing here?
I need to look you in the eye and ask you. Did you kill my husband?
No, Mrs. Henley. No, I didn't.
Yeah.
It's Margaret Bateman. I've had a chance to think it over.
Good. Been at the bank, I hope.
Well, where would you like to meet?
I thought the bar at the Marine Tower Hotel was kind of pleasant, didn't you?
Yeah, it was charming.
Why don't you meet me there in about a half hour? Yeah, I'll buy you another drink, and maybe you and I can get to know each other a little better.
Look, just have the negatives.
Yes, ma'am.
Offer testimony that shows indeed the accused had more than a boss-employee relationship with Mr. Henley. On the night in question, They did, in fact, have dinner.
Your Honor, my client has never denied being present at the apartment.
You're out of order, Mr. Moretti. Please proceed, Mr. Braxton.
It appeared to be a romantic dinner, but something went wrong. Evidence suggests a violent argument. We maintain that the accused killed Mr. Henley and then fled the apartment. We will show further that she took a watch from the scene and then later lied to the police about it. We shall also direct the court's attention to an incident that occurred in Albany, New York, approximately 2 months ago.
Your Honor, please. My name is Christine Henley. I have something to show the court.
Order. Order, please.
For starters, we're going to have to subpoena the guy who took these pictures.
You can't hold my client indefinitely while you investigate new evidence.
You presented this case as a crime of passion. This evidence seriously damages your allegations.
It's clear from these photographs that they were having an argument. She left the apartment, then she came back.
The burden of proof is on the people.
Your Honor, can I get a continuance?
Pending further investigation, this hearing is placed in continuance. The accused is released on her own recognizance.
Sir, I need to get a statement from you. You know, I wish I'd known earlier you were coming in with these photographs.
It wasn't easy, Detective.
No, I can't imagine that it was. She could have come back to the apartment later, you know.
Well, somebody must have. Well, please keep me informed.
Can you wait here a second?
Right. You take care.
Mrs. Henley. Thank you. I didn't do it for you.
Come on, let's get you checked out.
What's going on? What did they say?
They're going to try and find the guy that took the pictures. Mrs. Henley seems to think that he might have seen something, so we're just going to have to wait and see what happens.
Wait? Look, the person who put that watch in my trunk can't be too happy that I'm out of jail.
Go home and stay out of it. Look, they're just going to try and prove that you went back that night. So let them bark up the wrong tree for a little while. I mean, they're not going to find anything, are they? Come on, let's get your stuff.
Hello.
Yeah, it's Moretti. Okay, listen, they went to that detective's office.
Yeah? What did he say?
Okay, he wasn't there, but his sister who works for him 2 days a week says he split and she doesn't know where.
Are they looking for him?
Yeah, but like I said, just stay out of it. They got nothing, they just don't want to admit it, okay?
Okay, you were checked with all the neighbors on Henley's floor, right, Dan?
Same as before. Nobody saw or heard a thing.
I was afraid you were going to say that. Who was above, below?
Ditto.
Okay, I want the whole area canvassed. Neighbors, storekeepers, anybody might have seen her come back.
I keep telling everybody that my brother has gone.
Do you know where? I need to talk to him.
Oh, you and the whole world, it seems. Like I told the cops, it's not unusual for him to take off. I mean, his car is still here, so I figured that he flew to Atlantic City. I gotta do something about that damn dog.
His dog has been raising hell ever since he left. So guess who gets stuck with him? Okay, honey, if there's nothing else, I've got a lot of work to do.
Thank you.
Will you excuse me for just a moment?
Yeah, sure.
Of course.
What are you doing here?
Mrs. Henley, I need to talk to you.
Well, what makes you think I have anything to say to you?
The detective you hired. I just came from his office. He's gone.
Well, I don't know anything about him.
Well, how did you find him?
The phone book. Why are you asking me all this?
You think he's hiding something, don't you?
Look, this is a matter for the police.
Do you think he knows who killed your husband?
How dare you even mention my husband to me?
Mrs. Henley, please. Maybe he saw who it was. Maybe he got a picture.
Look, for the last time, I prefer that the police handle this. Now, goodbye.
The person who killed your husband is still out there, Mrs. Henley. I think that detective knows who it is.
I can't believe she had the nerve. What did she want?
Well, that detective I hired disappeared. She's trying to find him.
Why?
Well, not only does she think he saw Tom's murder, but she also thinks he might have photographed the killer.
Christine, maybe it's too soon for you to be here.
Oh, I'm going to be coming in quite a lot, actually. I have to decide what to do with the business. Keep it, sell it.
Sell it? You can't. I mean, I assume. Christine, I could run this business for you, and you would never have to think about it.
I know you could, Margaret.
Actually, Tom and I talked about my becoming a partner.
I don't know. Maybe I just won't concentrate on the gallery for now, you know?
Slide, are you here?
I forget to mention that I live in the apartment in back.
You do have the right to press charges, ma'am.
I just want all of you people to get out of here. Me and my brother just want to be left alone.
Well, I'll make sure you're not bothered again. Thank you.
Things weren't bad enough. Now we've got breaking and entering now, too?
I did not break in.
Oh, come on.
Why are you so convinced that I'm guilty?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe it's because you keep giving me reasons to arrest you.
Oh, so what? You're arresting me again? Is that it?
You're lucky she's not pressing charges. Otherwise, I would.
Does that mean I can go?
Yeah. Go on.
Laura.
Melanie.
I need to talk to you.
I can't right now. I'm doing her errands. Banking, car wash. It's Cinderella time.
It's just for a second. I'll go with you.
In her car? She'd kill me.
Laura, she'll never know. Please, it's very important.
Okay. We gotta hurry.
Excuse me, sir. Just hold the line
for
a minute.
Yeah, you gonna go to the game tonight?
Bert.
Yeah.
A guy named Brent Colbert on line two. I think you want to talk to him.
Who the hell is Brent Colbert?
Think you're gonna like this. Lives in Henley's building. Just got back from a business trip. Says he's got something to tell you.
I must have picked up my phone to call you 100 times.
Look, you know everybody in that office. I mean, is there anything that you can think of? A deal that went bad? Somebody he crossed? Anything?
Everyone liked Mr. Henley.
Somebody didn't.
Whoa.
Is he hot or not? How do I look?
Oh, fine.
So I got home and neighbors told me what happened. I figured I'd better talk to you fellas. Why don't you tell us what you saw? Okay, I was rushing through the lobby for this airport limousine, and I saw the girl, and I just had the suspicion that she wasn't from the building.
Okay, Mr. Colbert, why don't you tell us if the woman you saw is in one of these pictures?
That's her.
You're sure?
Yeah, I'm positive.
Oh, I'm late. It's film at 11.
Laura, has someone named Jonas Slide ever called Miss Bateman?
Doesn't sound familiar. Of course, a lot of people phone.
Look, I know that you write down all her calls. I need you to check your phone book. See if someone named Jonas Slide has called.
I just said it didn't sound familiar. Besides, I can't go rooting through her stuff. You know what she's like.
Laura, it's your phone book. She'll never know.
Why?
Because it's important. Laura, I need your help. Please.
Okay, but we gotta go.
I think you better get out here.
Jonah Slide, okay? Laura, I appreciate it.
Okay, I gotta go. I need to see you in my office right away. Shut the door. Why was she in my car?
She just wanted to talk.
Mm-hmm. Laura, you know better than that. She's a suspect in a murder case, and you could be charged as an accessory.
But she says she's innocent.
Oh, and you know more than the police, is that it?
No, of course not.
What did she want?
Nothing.
Laura, you just said she wanted to talk.
She just wanted to ask me some stuff.
What stuff? What stuff, Laura?
She wanted to know some guy had called here.
What guy?
A guy named Jonas Slide. But I said no, I'd never heard of him.
Laura, for your sake, I would stay away from her. And that'll be all. You can leave the door open. And Laura, please don't chew your gum in this office.
Matt, you cover the back.
I'm not sure she's in yet.
We'll soon find out.
Nothing, Bert.
Let's put out an APB.
Lied to me. Why the hell didn't you tell me that you went back?
I had already told them that I went right home. I knew it would look bad if I changed my story. Besides, I never saw him again. I never got in.
I'll try to help, but you gotta give yourself up.
You think they're gonna believe me now?
Look, there's not a damn thing I can do if you stay out there. Melanie, what are you doing?
Okay, Miss Webster. It's room 104. Just go down the end of the corridor. Check out at noon.
Bateman's office, hello.
Laura, it's Melanie.
Why are you calling me here?
Did you check the name?
I can't talk to you.
Laura, I can't. I'm sorry. Mrs. Henley, it's Melanie Brooke. I know you probably think that I'm guilty now more than ever, but I swear to you, I did not kill your husband. Look, I think I'm onto something, but I'm gonna need your help to put it together. I'll call you later.
Dr. Renikoff says he might see you.
Where?
Store over on 16th.
Melanie Brooke contacted me again today.
What?
Left a message on my machine. Said she was on to something, had to talk to me.
Do you have any idea what it's about?
No.
Well, they're going to find her, Christine, and then this will all be over. What is it?
There's something else.
You decided to sell the company, haven't you?
If I can get a decent offer, yeah.
Christine, I know this business inside out. I can run the company for you.
That's not the point. I want a clean start.
This is all Tom's fault.
This is my decision. It's got nothing to do with Tom.
It has everything to do with him.
No, it doesn't.
The affair hurting you, forcing you to hire that cowboy to take the photos. Christine, at the very least, let me show you the financial forecast. I have the documents in my office. I could bring them over to the house tonight.
Night, huh?
Yeah.
Hey, building security. Do you read?
Daniels.
Seems like we've got a code 4 with 23. Can you deal with it, please?
I'll take care of it. 200 grand a year and he gets locked out of his office every week.
Thank you.
Who is it?
Mrs. Henley. It's Melanie Brooke.
What do you want?
I have something I need to show you. Please, I think I know who killed your husband. The detective that you hired. You said you found him in the phone book, right?
Yes.
Did Margaret Bateman know him?
Well, of course not. Why?
This is Margaret's phone log. Her secretary writes down all her calls. Jonas Slide called her using a phony name. She talked to him a day before he disappeared. Look, these parking stubs. They're from the same hotel. I found one on Jonas Slide's car, the other inside Margaret's. Mrs. Henley, I'm convinced they knew each other.
But why would Margaret have anything to do with Slide?
Maybe she found out he got a picture that night. A picture of her.
You think Margaret killed Tom?
Yes. That's where I need your help. I mean, that's why I couldn't go to the police. Until I have proof, they're never going to believe me.
But they were friends. He gave her her job.
And I'm sure that she would do anything to keep it.
Margaret called Slide a cowboy.
How did she know what he looked like?
What?
I've got to call Detective Nagel.
Emergency services?
Yes, I need to speak to Detective Nagel. It's urgent.
Who's speaking, please?
Christine Henley.
I've told you before, Christine, you put the keys in such obvious places. Put the phone down.
Margaret.
I said put the phone down.
You did kill Tom.
Miss Henley?
Hello?
You broke in. She called the police. I had to stop you. I didn't want to kill you.
Yes, I need the police. Something awful has happened. She's killed Mrs. Henley.
That's where Slide is.
Now just take your time.
I was bringing by some financial papers, thank you, and I saw Melanie's car, and I came in the back. I always come that way.
Mm-hmm. Then what happened?
I came in, I heard arguing, and then a shot, and when I got to the front room, I saw Melanie running out, and Christine was... Then I just picked up the phone and called the police. Detective, I'm scared.
All right, Margaret. I've got you now.
Hello.
I figured it out. Everything.
No one will believe you.
They will when they see the pictures.
Pictures? What pictures?
Of you killing Tom.
I know where they are.
Oh, really?
I don't know where you buried Slide, but I'm gonna find him. And when I do,
it's all over for you.
And what does that mean?
The pictures are hidden on his body.
You're lying.
Really? You're betting an awful lot on that.
I need you to get a car to 227 in Vale Drive.
Ma'am, what's this about?
Listen to me. Get a message to Detective Nagel, 34th Precinct, that the person who killed Tom Henley is here, and that someone else has also been killed, a man named Jonah Slide.
Who is this?
It doesn't matter who this is. Just get somebody out here now.
Melanie!
I've just called the police. They're on their way.
Good. Saves me the trouble. You know, you keep getting yourself into these messes. You lured me here. They know that I had to defend myself with a gun that you stole from Jonas Slide. Very clever bringing me over the photos are, do you? You just wanted to prove that I know where the body was.
It worked.
Except that now you get to join Jonas Slide.
now, move!
Wait a minute! What is going on here? Where's Detective Nagel? I can't believe this. Listen to me, you're making a mistake. You're making a mistake.
Boy. Here we go again.
Listen to me. She was trying to kill me. She killed that detective.
You don't give up, do you?
I am telling you, he is buried out back.
We should take a look.
Into your pockets. Take off your belt.
Body.
Give me your shoes.
I need to talk to Detective Nagel.
I said, give me your shoes.
Listen to me, damn it. I need to talk to him now.
Well, at least we know where she is. With her, I'm not so sure.
I can't believe she actually told us where she buried the body.
It just doesn't make sense. What doesn't?
Out of all the cases I've worked on, this is the first one where the murder suspect is called the police. I don't know.
Mitchum. Yeah. Okay. Get this. Our murder suspect wants us to go to the morgue. Something about a belt.
Here you go, Bert. Let me know when you're done.
Yeah, thanks, Al.
Was I right?
I have a message for you. Melanie Brooke. Your prints are in. Where do you go from here?
Start over. Another job wouldn't hurt.
Right, we're always swamped around here. We use temps from time to time.
I think I've had enough of police stations, if it's all the same to you. Besides, no more office work for a while.
Office work? No, I was thinking about assigning you to a couple of unsolved cases.
From what I've seen around here, I think you could use the help.
I'll let you know.